Welcome to Nugget 206 with Steve Grohman, and we will be taking you to one of our favorite places. It's called Yellowstone National Park, and this was our 8th visit to this splendid place. We've been going for actually 20 years now.
Remember the first time you wanted to go there? I said, nah, not that big a deal. It stinks and it all looks the same.
Yeah, well, they don't stink. I love that smell.
It is
even
awesome
though
thing.
It says in the brochures that toxic gases exist in Yellowstone. Dangerous levels of hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide have been measured in some hydrothermal areas. If you feel sick, leave the location immediately. Well, I'm one of those crackpots.
We've never felt sick.
That I like to stand in the heat that comes off of them and smell the aroma. I guess to most people it stinks, but to me it means I'm happy because I'm at Yellowstone.
Yeah, I remember this time when we were there, there was a young elk drinking out of one of those.
Yeah.
And they have these signs all over the place warning to stay away and boiling hot and it'll kill you and all that. This guy's standing in there drinking out of it.
Yeah, she was having a... Her evening tea,
I guess. Yeah, I guess so.
But we'll
show you... No wonder they're so healthy.
Couple of pictures as we roll through pictures as we talk of an area of Yellowstone called West Thumb, and it sits on the thumb of Lake Yellowstone. It is the largest lake at high elevation in North America. Its elevation is at 7,733 feet. That's almost a mile and a half.
Yeah.
It's way up there. It takes in an area of 136 square miles, has 110 miles of shoreline, and it is 14 miles in width and 20 miles in length. And it's a great place for catch and release anglers to go. I don't get that.
You never have gotten that.
I'm not sure
I do either.
But we won't get into that.
We have
a really good friend that he earns a living doing that. So whatever.
Catching fish and letting them go again.
Yeah.
Catch them again.
Let's take you to West Thumb. West Thumb, as I was saying, is on the western side of Lake Yellowstone. And it's really one of the most unique set of geysers because it is on the lake shore. It is one of the least popular places, but we always go there because it's not crowded, mainly.
It's not crowded. It's a big, massive, beautiful area.
We went there at sunset and hiked the trails. Lady elks were following us all around. But you know, we like to read the signs. And we're going to read the one main sign that was at West Thumb, and we're going to talk about it for a few minutes.
It says, an exploded bay. West Thumb's shoreline has suspiciously crater-like contours. That's suspiciously. It makes sense to me. But anyway, its underwater profile is dramatically deeper than the rest of Yellowstone Lake. Only a massive explosion could have formed West Thumb. You kind of can see the evidence of a mass explosion of some sort in that whole area. Though the blowout occurred 125,000 years ago, well, that way problem. West Thumb is still thermally active.
Hot springs, mud pots, and geysers steam and percolate along the shore, and temperature gauges record high heat flow in lake bottom sediments. And then they have this map, and you can see where West Thumb sits in the order of things. And Yellowstone Lake and all this is in the southeast quadrant of Yellowstone National Park. This diagram here of volume of magma as it's erupted and it's going through, and we're fairly certain that that's what happened when the fountains of the Great Deep broke up.
Yes. Yes. And there's good evidence for it. When the fountains broke up, this thing, it was chaos. But it's beautiful now.
It's almost like God gave us Yellowstone and similar places, which there aren't very many, to say, hey, here's an example of what I did and what it looked like.
They have a petrified forest out in Yellowstone also, which is really, really interesting. It's 27 distinct layers of fossil forest, they say. And we'll have to do a nugget on that because we remember going up to the top of that thing.
Vividly.
A helicopter would have been kind of nice.
Anything. I was willing to slide down on a piece of cardboard.
We are climbers and hikers, and we are outdoor people, and that thing was brutal. It was the worst hike we ever did, but it was awesome when we got on top.
When I got to the top, I held on to one of those petrified trees, and I cried.
Not
because
literally.
The petrified tree, I was excited to see it, because I was hurting.
Yeah,
it was grueling, but...
It was brutal, but it was worth it.
At the time, I was questioning that. But we just want to show
you... Not many people do
you.
It, though. Not many people get up there, so it was awesome.
We just want to show you the beauty of Yellowstone and this not-so-popular area of it. And these signs are everywhere, and the date is wrong. As we keep repeating, it wasn't 125,000 years ago. It was 4,400 years ago, and it was at Noah's flood. And I just truly believe that the Lord has just left us a little sampling.
In this depiction here, you know, it says volume of magma erupted. That may well well be true. It may well be partially true. But also, we got to realize sinkhole activity does a lot of the same kind of characteristics that you can find in this in these types of features.
Right. And they're always talking about the caldera because Yellowstone, there is it activity is still going on.
Right.
And
right.
I know a lot of geologists are concerned about this whole park and this whole region that one day it just might blow
again. Yeah, they've actually
again.
Been saying for years now, Yellowstone is about to blow. And very well, it might. It might.
I hope not.
The individual geysers, when they go, they're really neat because they can usually time them pretty quick. It would let you know that 4 hours or 4.5 hours this one's going to go, and another 3 hours this one will go again. And we catch a lot of them that way. We go back that same time frame when it's supposed to go, and sure enough, there it goes. It's beautiful. It's awesome.
And you can see in this map a partial, the red dashed lines that are marking the Yellowstone caldera. We do know that this earth will melt with fervent heat.
Yes.
And it will end in fire. Maybe that will be the time Rip. When the Yellowstone volcanoes just end
God,
it all.
God says, let her go. Let it go. Here we go. It's going to be awesome. Yeah, if you ever get a chance to go to Yellowstone, you're ever out west, no matter where you are, do it. You ought to stop and see it. And don't just do the touristy stuff of Old Faithful. I mean, it's Old Faithful's nice, but there's a lot more to see, a lot more neat things to see than just the one geyser.
And you can use my Often on the Beaten Path as a guidebook because we have been there so many times. I have exhaustive information in that book about what to do and what to see. And even when we went there the other day, we did something new that we had never done.
Yeah.
And the guidebooks all say, do one of these out-of-the-way places. And we did that. And we were the only ones out there.
Yep, that's okay.
That's okay.
It's still awesome.
All right, well, thank you.